you want to show them where Ukraine is on the map.
United States, Canada, South America, Africa, Russia, and then Ukraine. Spain, France, the Great Britain, Sweden, Germany, Poland, Ukraine, here, Black Sea, here, Turkey, here, Mediterranean.
How do you say good morning, beautiful people, in Russian?
In Russian, Доброго дня, in Ukraine. So it's very close languages.
And you speak both?
Of course.
Of course, well.
I speak German, of course, because I was teaching for 5 years in German, and I speak a little French.
That's pretty impressive. What do you guys think? So, how old were you when you started playing the piano?
I was 6 when my mom wanted desperately me to play the piano.
So your mom pushed you to play?
Oh, yes.
Did you enjoy playing the piano at a young age?
Playing for fun, yes. Practicing, not, but it's like every kid, you know.
And how often did you have to practice when you started?
Every day, of course.
Every day for how long?
Well, maybe at the beginning, 1-2 hours, and then when I get to be professional, at least 3 hours a day.
3 hours a day? Oh, wow, at least 3 hours a day. That's quite a commitment. What did you start playing? What were your first songs? Do you want to give us a little sample?
You know, I begin to be 47 now, so just my memory is already gone for this repertoire. But something simple, you know, we had some books, you know, Nikolaevsky or Chernyov, just anything. Something simple. But maybe my first thing, what I tried to play the piano, was some melodies, what I heard from the television. My father was actually an opera singer, so I heard the operas. Age 3 or 4. My first visit to the opera theater in province of Soviet Union, in the city called Ufa, was a very funny one. So there is a very famous opera written by a French composer, Charles Gounod. It's called Faust. So it's based on the Goethe Faust. So my father was singing in this particular day, singing the main role. He was singing Mephistopheles, so it's like a devil. So he was. Accordingly, he was dressed and he had a kind of outfit and how do you say, maquillage? Not mask.
Makeup.
Right. No, I don't make makeup, that's why this what is kind of lacking in my vocabulary for every day. So he went on the stage looking like really like a devil, and my mom was sitting near me. I was 3 years old. She said, "Hey, that's Papa." I started immediately crying. Like, "No, no, that's not Papa. No, that." She took me away, you know. That was my first experience, but second servant was already okay.
And what do you today?
I will start my program with German, Austrian German composer Franz Schubert. I'll play 3 impromptu of him, Opus 90.
And can you explain what those are? What is that?
That's relatively short pieces, about 3, 4, 5 minutes long each. Well, generally speaking, you have 1 or 2 musical contrasted ideas which come sometimes into conflict, come sometimes into harmony. It's very peaceful music and very melodical one.
Let's put our hands together for Oleg. Let's first thank you.
Thank you.
Do you want to explain why?
No, it's not in the tradition of the classical music concert.
I had a question for you. Where have you traveled as a pianist around the world?
It's my 18th visit to the United States. I was 13 times in Japan, 12 times in South Korea, 2 times in China. 20 in Germany, France, Poland, Ukraine, many years of concert activities in Russia, of course. So that's my major destinations. Of course, I was in Spain, in Portugal, in England. No, it's mostly in Switzerland, Italy.
And do you have any advice for someone who is interested in taking piano lessons?
Be patient and be and work hard, and then maybe you will succeed with this.
I think we have enough time for one more short piece. Do you have something up your sleeve? Let's give him another round of applause. Take this performance and just have a wonderful day.